My dear friends, residents, all in Bukit Timah, Bukit Panjang. It is a very special moment for me to stand here before you in this field, to see so many of you here, to also see my father, my wife in the audience. Just now, Mr. Liang Ying Hua said that he was educated in Bukit Panjang English School. 57 years ago, my father and my mother were teachers in Bukit Panjang School. That's where they met, and as a result, I'm here. The school has shifted a bit, but the actual site is 10 Mile Junction, where the LRT is. Every time I drive past there, I'm reminded that this place is special. But let me, if you don't mind, share a story which I've shared before in Parliament, but I think many of you may not have heard it, and I want to repeat it again today. Because I want you to look into my heart and understand why I'm doing what I'm doing. My mother's father, my grandfather, passed away when he was on a business trip in China. I think this was about 82, 83 years ago, just before my mother was born. That left my grandmother a young widow with two children and one more, my mom. Life was very tough. She had no work. The family business was run by other relatives, and she had to depend on handouts and an allowance from relatives and friends. My mother grew up deprived, very, very skinny. She had TB, and when she met my father, she told him that she would probably be infertile because she was so well-nourished. We know, of course, she was wrong because she ended up with five children. But that childhood poverty made a deep impact on her life. She only lived for 70 years, but she could never spend money. She could never waste money. She was always counting. There's no small change, you know, counting every bit. And not for herself, but for her children and her family. And she also drilled into us some lessons in life. What are these lessons? One, that life is unpredictable. Bad things can happen to good people, and you don't know when it can happen. And two, when things like that happen, you have to depend on your relatives, your closest friends, because you only know who is really reliable when something bad happens. The third thing she taught me was always be prepared. Always have savings. Always be sure, clear that when something goes wrong, you have another plan. And the fourth lesson she taught me was that you have to work hard. Because it is only through hard work, through education, through getting a career, that you can make progress and you can provide for your family. I tell you all these things because this is why I am in politics. This is why I make the decisions I make and the policies which I roll out in MCYS. My friends, this election is not an easy election. I think you all know me now. I'm a very, very honest minister. This is not an easy election. Why is it not an easy election? I think there is one key question the voters of Singapore are asking us. That question is, do you care? Do you care about me? It's not a matter of how smart you are. It's not a matter of how detailed your plans are, but your heart. And for those of us standing as candidates of the PAP, we need to remind ourselves and remind the voters of Singapore that we care for you. We will look after you. In everything that we do, sometimes tough, sometimes unpopular, is because we care for you. The last few weeks, I have not been making many speeches because my teammates, including Dr. Teo, my new colleague, Ms. Sim Ann, have been meeting thousands of people. And I say thousands because we've been making house visit after house visit after house visit, market visits, meeting people. When we meet these people, I don't give them a long talk, a long speech. I ask them one question. What are you concerned with? What are you afraid of? What is your hopes? What is your fear? And for this election, people have told me a few things. Almost everyone I meet is concerned about the cost of living. Almost everyone I meet is concerned about jobs. Almost everyone I meet is concerned about the cost of homes. And almost everyone I meet is concerned about their children. So let's just tonight, without any big fiery speeches, just consider these 4 points. The cost of living, our jobs, our homes, and our children. First thing I want to tell you is that the government, the PAP, and the people are on the same side. The opposition wants you to believe that we are creating the problems for you, that we are making things worse for you. That is not true. Let's deal with the first issue, the cost of living. Everything we eat, we drink, we use, even the clothes that we wear, where do we get it from? Where is it from? It's overseas, right? Do we determine the prices that the overseas countries charge us for our food, for oil, for our clothes, for all the things that we use in our daily life? We don't, you know. This is just Singapore, 3.2 million citizens. We cannot control global prices. If there's instability in the Middle East, oil prices rise. If you get a drought or a flood in agricultural countries, food prices rise. If there's a harvest failure for cotton, even clothing prices will rise. So understand, this is not something that the PAP has done to our people, but something that happens as a result of worldwide developments. But the PAP, the government, has to do something about it. So what do we do to help you cope with the cost of living? Yesterday, the Prime Minister said, the most effective long-term solution to dealing with rising costs is to raise your salaries.